Okay, welcome to the press conference after a pursuit. Men with the winner, Marta Fourcade from France, and the second place to Lucas Hofer, third place Johannes Thingnes Bø. Marta Fourcade, a lovely day in Holmenkollen, and yet another win for you. How easy was it today?
It wasn't, because the fight on the beginning was really tight. And I had a lot of pressure on the standings shooting, so I must say I'm really satisfied about the win today. I heard it's my 10th win in Holmenkollen, and I'm the most awarded by athlete in Holmenkollen, so that's a big pride, and it's probably my favorite place in the World Cup, so I'm really happy I did that.
You said you had your family at the stadium today. Did that help?
I must say I thought about it during the competition, and it's not something you have to do. But at the end, I catch the victory, so it was not a bad idea. But I was amazed by how many French people were there to celebrate our good season, to celebrate Marie Dorin's retirement, and. It's really good to feel this support by the French people, and of course by my two little queens today.
Marie Dorabert and the French team won the relay for the women. Were you inspired by them before the start?
I try to avoid looking so much biathlon before my competition, because I prefer to stay focused on what I have to do. But of course I knew that the girls won the race, and It's an amazing gift for Marie Dorin. You know, she's ending a beautiful biathlon career, and she's a good friend of mine outside of biathlon. And I must say that I'm so happy she can end her career in a good way, like she is doing since the Olympics. She had a really difficult beginning of the season, and seeing her smile here in Holmenkollen, feeling that she can retire quietly. Being happy of what she achieved is perhaps the best gift she could make herself.
Final question, the fight for the overall cup against Johannes, 49 points now between you two in your favor. How would you see on the last weekend in Tumen fighting for the yellow jersey yet another year?
Yeah, it's a really nice fight, and I must say I'm surprised, but I like it. And Johannes is an amazing opponent, and no matter what happened since Tumen, I know that I will thank him for the fight we had. Even if he wins the World Cup, I don't want it, but I really appreciate the fair fight we have, and the good biathlon show we are offering to people. And 50 points seems a lot, but we saw on the women competition that only one sprint missed, and everything can be different. So I know that for me now, I need to do one beautiful sprint in Tumen, and if I achieve that with the chance, I can still miss, because there is two withdraw, and I used only one. It will be on a good way for the title, but for now I'm only focusing on the sprint, because I know it will be again a great fight with Johannes.
Thank you, good luck with that. Lucas Hofer, first podium in 4 years, that was the win in Antols. Describe your race in Holmenkollen.
I tried to stay always there with the other guys, because I saw them in front, and I didn't want to lose the gap behind them, and by the end I tried to stay focused on my shooting. I was not shooting fast today, because I wanted to get out of the shooting range as much as possible to keep the speed also on the track, and by the end I was really happy and satisfied about, especially about the shooting, and finally I was able to climb the podium again.
As a speaker for the Norwegian crowd, we were seeing the difference between you and Johannes on the last lap, and he did gain something, but then you hold the position. How was the fight on the last lap, and how much power did you have left?
I went out and my trainer told me it's only a small gap, about 4 seconds, and so I think they told me this just that I'm keeping pushing on the last loop and I try to keep some energy on the last 600 meters by the end. And when I saw Johannes that I had a bigger gap to him, so I was really happy that I was able to finish a bit slower than before.
And then there's your mustache, because you're at the podium, but you didn't shoot clean, so it's still going to be in your face, so to say. For how long do you hope?
It's the 12th time that I missed one this year, so it's a bet with the brother from my girlfriend, and I will keep my word, and hopefully there are 4 more races missing, so I hope I will be able to cut it by the end of the season.
It will be a great moustache by the start of next season, though, if you miss all in Tumen. You have to save the whole summer.
No, we decided that we have time only over the season, so at least over summer I can cut it.
Okay, good luck with that. Johannes Tingnesbø, yet another podium for you as well, 3rd place today. And how about the last lap against Hofer? Did you think you could catch him?
I knew Hofer is one of the strongest guys on the last laps, but I was feeling really good today, so I was thinking there was a chance. We had really good material on the skis, and I had a good shape today. But in the end of the last lap, I saw there was no chance. So then it was just to look behind and secure the 3rd place.
Not a great start at the shooting, and in total 4 penalty loops today. What happened?
hard to describe by words, but I'm just not happy about my biathlon game today. But still, I am on the podium, and I'm happy with that. But I have to be on a higher level on my next races if I want to make the big fight with Marta.
Yeah, because that's the next question. 49 points now up to Marta Farkad without the withdrawals. So how do you see the fight next weekend?
I think I have maybe 10% chance to win this. So it's not a big chance, but you know, it's much thing can happen. And I know for sure that Marta will probably be on the podium every race next weekend. And then there is no chance for me to win the globe, so I just have to do my best, and we'll see. It's been a good season, no matter what happened next weekend, and it's a big step during my career.
Thank you, good luck, and congratulations. And I think we can just open for one-to-one interviews. Thank you.